Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemy.
This is Naveen and part of the instructor team at MakerDemy.
In this episode, you will learn about wildcards in MQTT and why it is important. If you have been watching our MQTT video series till now, I guess you will have an overall idea of the different features of MQTT like quality of service, last will and testament, and retain messages. If this is your first time here, we highly recommend you to go through those videos before continuing. Let us again look at the HVAC factory example application we covered in the last will and testament video. Let's imagine that a similar system is deployed in a large office space where we have deployed sensors to measure temperature, humidity, and pressure of individual rooms. There might be hundreds of sensors constantly publishing the sensor values to the broker. You will only need a few subscriber clients to handle all the operations of the HVAC, like a dashboard client, an automation client, an emergency notification client, and so on. Let's take the dashboard client as an example. The purpose of the dashboard is to collect all the sensor data and give an overall idea of the environmental conditions of each room in the office. Thus, at any point in time, the dashboard has to connect to a large group of sensors based on the room or the rooms which are selected to be monitored. It would be a pain for developers to individually subscribe to each topic one after the other based on the requirement. Moreover, individually subscribing to each topic name is time and resource consuming, as individual subscribe packets have to be sent for each topic. What if we can subscribe to multiple topics at the same time, that too by sending a single subscribe packet? Yes, this can be done using wildcards in MQTT. Wildcards, also known as wildcard characters, are symbols used as placeholders to replace or represent one or more characters. There are two different kinds of wildcards. They are single-level wildcard represented by a plus symbol and a multi-level wildcard represented by a hash symbol. It is also to be noted that wildcards are only used to subscribe to topics and not to publish. Before we look at the working of the two wildcards, let's assume the following topics are created in the broker by the publisher clients. As the name suggests, a single level wildcard replaces one topic level. For example, let's say you want to know all the temperature and humidity readings of the whole ground floor. Then the dashboard client will send a subscribe packet with the following topic name: /plus/sensor A/+. Thus, now with this single subscribe packet, the dashboard client is subscribed to all these topics. Similarly, to get all the temperature and humidity values of the whole office, we can use the following topic pattern: +/plus/sensor A/+. Now let's look at the second wildcard. The hash wildcard is a multi-level wildcard which is always placed as the last character in the topic and preceded by a forward slash. Let's say that you need to subscribe to all sensor readings of the lab in the first floor. Then we can use the hash wildcard like shown here. The dashboard client will be subscribed to all the topics of both the sensor A and sensor B in this case. When a client subscribes to a topic with a multi-level wildcard, it receives all messages under that level, no matter how long or deep the topic's hierarchy is. We can also combine single and multi-level wildcards for gaining more control over the subscriptions. For example, for the topic pattern given here, the client dashboard will be subscribed to all the temperature and humidity readings of both the rooms in the first floor. Let's say that after some months, we have upgraded the sensor A in the first floor to also detect light intensity. Still, with the existing wildcard implementation, you will be getting subscribed automatically to any new topics created under sensor A of the first floor. We hope that with these examples, you are able to understand the implementation and importance of wildcards in MQTT. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.